I'm Mashu Scanlon, the guy on the left.
This is Paul Cheon, also known as Humph.
Join us on Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. Pacific for Magic TV, where we answer the burning questions posed to us by you, the audience, like Chipotle or La Vic, or where do these guys get their hair done?
And also every single week, we're going to be having a special guest from Channel Fireball, like Louis Scott Vargas, Josh Arleighton, Tom Martell, and many others.
With all that and Dark Steel Humphrey, we'll see you next Wednesday.
Hey guys, this is Pat Cox, and today I'm going to be playing an 8-man with Abzan Aggro. I'm sure most of us are familiar with how this deck works by now, but you know, basically has a mid-range feel despite being called an aggro deck. There's a lot of different flavors of Abzan, but this one can potentially get under the decks that go bigger, unlike Abzan Control or you know decks that play Elspeth and Corsair Crew Fix. So I haven't actually played a lot of Standard since GB Toronto, but I did play a deck very similar to this there. And I'm kind of curious, like I know the deck to beat right now is Green Red Devotion, kind of curious if Abzan Aggro can go under it. Maybe it can, maybe it can't. I guess the main concession I made to that deck was having the full number of Abzan Charms, just Death Mist Raptors kind of all over the place. I actually played it in the last Pro Tour right when it first came out, but I haven't played it since. But it is a pretty good card, so the ability to exile it is pretty important. Also, I like Wingmate to fly over it. Previously, I had liked Whisperwood Elemental more in that slot, but I think Wingmate could be the way to go here. And then the other sort of weird thing is I'm trying one Dem Protector main just as a way to gain advantage in longer games. I have not really liked Tassigar in that role. I mean, it's a good card. It's mostly good just because you can play it. It allows you to play two cards in one turn by delving. Like, the getting back cards is fine, but it's pretty rare that you get back something great without, like it, you know, it either dies or they just give you back something you didn't really need, like a Thoughtseize or whatever. So anyway, our sideboard is kind of just an assortment of cards I wanted to try. Like I said, I think Wingmate's better in general, but Whisperwood's still going to be better some of the time, so in grindy matchups, want to have access to both, I think. You know, the Drowns and Bioblights are mostly for red aggro decks. Yeah, so let's go ahead and start round one here. Hey guys, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to round one of a Standard Daily here on Channel Fireball. Yeah, this opening hand is good enough. We'll keep. We're on the draw. It is a little bit slow. We don't have a one or two drop, despite having tons of those in our deck. But we could potentially scry to one, and just, you know, in general, this is, it would be a bit greedy to mulligan this. Well, we found a two drop. Can't necessarily cast a turn two, but that's okay. So we'll go ahead and scry, see what we get. I think we're going to have to bottom that. We're looking for a third, fourth, and fifth land at this point. And we're potentially playing the mirror. You know, that Sansep Citadel, as I said before, it means an Abzan deck, but there's a lot of flavors of that. Okay, well, he's hit me at least once with this Fleece Man, so I guess I'm looking for an untapped land here. Like, my mana is good enough with these two that there's not a lot of reason to play the Sandstep. And while this is good in the mirror, we are still just looking for land, so I gotta bottom this. Which is why scry lands are so awesome. Like, I would have just bricked twice on lands there, and, you know, now I got a chance. Like, I already hit one, so. Alright, well. So. We can play a Death Dealer right now, and that's it. That doesn't block either thing effectively. We can Thoughtseize and try and take his next play, but we're taking seven. We're taking eight if we do that. Though unless we're chump blocking, we're taking that much anyway. Really need an untapped land there. If I could just Abzan Charm one of these guys, I'd be in pretty decent shape. But the inability to play a real blocker is it's gonna be brutal. Like, if I can Siege Rhino next turn, then I might be able to gain some tempo back if he doesn't have a removal spell. So I guess I Thoughtseize him. It's like, not good. I'm going to take a million damage, but I don't know how I'm winning playing Death Dealer or not being able to block with it. Well, the Rhino is probably the more immediate threat, but it is pretty awkward how he can just downfall my Rhino if he does that. So let's see. So I'm about to go to 15, then I'm going to go to, from the Thought Seize, then I'm going to go to 7 from the attack. And then he's going to play Siege Rhino, which puts me to 4. So if I just play a Siege Rhino, I'm straight up dead. Because, yeah. He'll just, I can only block one of the guys even. Alright, so yeah, I guess I gotta take Siege Rhino here. I think the odds of me winning this game are incredibly low, but if he draws air a couple times, we might be okay. Obviously, him scrying does not help that, but all right. Yeah, playing Siege Rhino doesn't really do a lot for me. The main advantage of it is it A eats removal spell, and B I could potentially play two things the next turn. But I mean, I can play two guys right now. That doesn't really do much. I can play an offense and have a, yeah, okay. I can't play just any creature. I can play a removal spell if I want. So if I Abzan Charm, I'll go to 3. And I have another Abzan Charm waiting in the wings. So that, I can also play a Death Dealer to jump block if he has another guy. So that is probably the correct play. And then I guess I just want to do it on the Fleece Man, right? Like, I should just do it now. I don't really want him to get a fifth land, and I need to do it on both at some point, so. There's no actual reason to do it upkeep there. I should have just done it in my main phase. Luckily, it's not like Valor Stance can stop that, so. Valor Stance makes it indestructible, doesn't give it Hexproof or Shroud or anything like that. Alright, well, I'm dead to a Siege Rhino, but he clearly doesn't have one at least yet. Okay, so can play Death Dealer and exile that idiot. I guess that's pretty good. Tap this for black from Urborg so I don't take damage. I don't need white. I don't know why I did that. So that still leaves white, green, black. Okay. Guess there's no reason to do main phase here because I want him to like potentially spew off his downfall, tapping my guy down. I mean, yeah, I just have to let it die, I guess, right? So I don't want this exile. It's like there's some chance I want Den Protector back. Probably not, but there's no reason to not do this now. So my guy goes to graveyard. Fade a Siege Rhino for return. I can maybe win the game. Oh man. I thought I was coming back into it, but no. Okay. So, kind of want the grindy crab in the mirror. The Den Protector is probably good. Sorin's actually just kind of medium. But, I mean, it's fine. Both Death Dealer and Warden are pretty mediocre. They're just kind of like mana intensive and don't do a lot, so. Won't necessarily be cutting all of them, but we'll see here. Thought Seize is also kind of hit or miss. So probably want the downfall. Ultimate Price just kills zero things. Self-inflicted wound is good. Cut's probably good because it lets you cast multiple things in a turn. I guess we can just keep a Death Dealer. So it's definitely possible this is just too much expensive crap and I'm going to get run over. Which is why I'm kind of trying to try it out. But yeah, I don't think I can actually side all these things in, which means why are they on my sideboard if that's the case? Don't know. Good question. yeah, we'll see. But I don't think that's good. Okay, yeah, let's go with this. Like, it's weird because, like, there are games where Death Dealer just is great and wins in the mirror, but as you saw there, you're often so constrained on mana that it's not realistically going to happen. It's like these weird games where you're flooded where it happens. Alright, well, no scry lands and only a Thoughtseize. Yeah, I think this is Mulligan. Alright, this is good. I would even venture to say this is great, so we'll keep. See, now Fleece Mane is big enough on its own, and if you invest mana once, that's all you need to do. So I think we don't need a land right now. So Fleece Mane is pretty great. I mean, I think you saw like Abzan control decks were like siding that in against aggro decks. So that should tell you it's probably something you want in the mirror type matchup. Okay, so we drew another temple. But I think we're just going to go with Fleece Mane. He plays his own. I can just self-inflicted wounds. Then I still have Hero's Downfall for his next play. Okay, so I guess we'll see what we got on top first. It's probably going to be pretty good. I mean, we already have five lands. If we can find a window where he taps out, like even just getting one guy is probably good enough. So. Yeah, this is more or less how I lost for day two of Toronto, is playing the mirror and just self-inflicted wound kind of helped get me run over. Alright, well, I guess I should probably check what I have on top first. I don't think it hugely matters, but let's just correct play. Alright, well, I have five lands already, and two of them are green, so bottom. And the way this game is played out is also just, like, very likely that he has to tap out this turn, meaning I'm going to get a guy off Whisperwood. And I don't have to play it if he doesn't. Because the other thing is there's, like, this tension where he, like, wants to kill this now before I have monstrous mana. There you go. So, yeah. Well, I put a land or waste on the bottom, so that's kind of nonsense that I drew in anyway. That just seems unfair. But, yeah, I think, you know, even if he kills us now, we're still in decent shape. So what do we get? And a Fenza. That's pretty lucky. Just actually got a guy that can do something. Thing is, I would not in any way say flooded, but we only have lands as things to do right now. That's pretty good to get a guy that we can actually use. Well, I'd rather that not be exiled because I have Den Protector in our deck, so I'll sacrifice it. Ooh, that's interesting. Do I bash for two more, or do I leave up regenerate on my Death Dealer? I think I like bashing. I guess he could just have Murderous Cut here, right? Not that it really matters if I attack first or not with that, but Well, now the question is, do I play this? I think it's right. I think I just play it, but there could be an argument made for sitting back on it. Given that I could draw like an Urborg, or just in general how mana hungry this deck is, I don't really want to screw around. Just drop, play my lands. There's not a ton of reason to when I don't have any other cards in hand. Like I could threaten, like, oh, I have some big follow up, but obviously he doesn't have removal or he would have used it, so. First card's a decent draw. Now, he's played two Abzan Charms, which is also doing nothing, so. I guess I'm not gonna pump, because he could just have Abzan Charm, and otherwise he can't kill this guy. It's kind of awkward. It's like, I could just be, like, spewing off winning faster. Alright, well, he probably doesn't have it now. Like, I think after he's cast three, I can feel safe to pump. Though, yeah, that was good that I didn't pump. Is this one death dealer going to go the distance after I was like, yeah, death dealer's not good in the mirror? Maybe. What do you got over there? It's a lot of mana. I hope it's not an Elspeth. Nissa. So, that doesn't matter too much, really. Yeah, he's dead. Okay. Whatever, I only have one stupid delve card in my deck, so. Alright, we did it. Yeah, I don't know. I've definitely found mirror games are not quite as grindy as you would think they might end up. Which means why am I siding in all this grindy stuff? Because it's haymaker after haymaker. It's weird. Yeah, I don't know if I side anything differently on the draw. Like, I still don't think I really want Bioblight. Like, it does kill, like, a Fleece Mane. But it also kills my own Fleece Mane. It doesn't kill anything else, that, at least anything that matters. I mean, I could see wanting more early stuff on the draw, but the problem is that, like, Death Dealer still just doesn't block Fleece Mane, so what is it doing for me? Warden kind of does. Like, if I go turn one Warden, turn two Pump, I can block his Fleece Mane, but. Nah, we'll stay with this, I guess. Just hope I have a Thoughtseize or something early. Alright, well, that's probably enough early stuff. I'll keep. I guess the question is, do I want to play the Scryland, or I think I want to play the Sandstep, A, because it gives me more outs to top deck a way to play Fleece Mane, and B, it lets me Thoughtseize next turn. Well, I definitely do now, because now I can just play my Fleece Mane, or depending on what he does, but anyway. And then also, like, let's pretend that I didn't draw another land there, and I just had these two lands. I could Thoughtseize, see what he has, take what I need to take, and then play this to see, like, to get something that deals with whatever his next thing is. So yeah, the question is, do I want a Thoughtseize? Do I want a self-inflicted wound? Do I want to play my own Fleece Mane? Like, if I play my own Fleece Mane and he plays a removal spell, it's not really that bad for me. I can catch back up by just playing self-inflicted wound. So, yeah, I guess Fleece Mane's correct. It's really only bad if he has, like, Dromoka's Command, which I think is more or less fallen out of favor. I have two in the main deck, because I still like it, but it has gotten a good bit worse. There's not as many enchantments around. Alright. Well, I guess we'll start with seeing what's up. I mean, having an untapped land is not nothing. Like, it does let me go Anafenza and Thoughtseize next turn or Siege Rhino next turn. But I also don't really want to get flooded. I already have plenty of lands. It's kind of awkward. I think I'd want to bottom this. Like, I would not be unhappy drawing an untapped land next turn, but I'm also don't really want to run out of cards first. Well, I'm going to have to take a pretty big hit, but I got a couple Siege Rhinos coming up to help me, so probably not in the worst shape. Guess this again? Alright, bottom. I don't know why I hit white. Let's go black, green, white. Well, hopefully it doesn't have anything too crazy here. Definitely behind. As you can see, being on the play is pretty important in the mirror. And I mean, I might have even just screwed up turn two. It's hard. I don't know. Like, maybe I just kill this guy and then I don't have, like, yeah, I don't know. That is kind of annoying, but can't really do much besides just play Siege Rhino. Probably should have played the land first. Lets me Rhino and double Thoughtseize next turn. I can't imagine I'm going to need two Thoughtseizes at this point in the game. I think it's just he's not going to have enough gas left to even use it. Well, so I think worst case, I'm going to be able to kill his Anafenza. I guess if he has, like, Abzan Charm to pump his Anafenza. Like, I don't need a double. If he attacks with this, I'm double blocking with these two. Because if I double block here, this is going to become a 5-6. And then if he removes this, I get really screwed. This way, I'm guaranteeing he dies, even if he has an Abzan Charm to pump. Like, if I only blocked with this, he could just pump. But anyway, if he pumps, he has three in yard, so he could potentially, two of his three cards are Abzan Charm and, Murderous Cut, it is really bad for me, but just taking a million is also bad for me, so I guess I'm gonna hope that's not the case. Alright. Well, yeah, I don't think I can possibly win. I don't even know he's casting, but alright, so that's gonna become a 6 when he attacks. So I straight up just can't use these Thoughtseizes. Yeah. Because the only profitable block I have is Anafenza. I mean, you can just only attack with that guy. Alright. Based on the Rhino, I'm screwed. Just the fact I need another Rhino to even, like, use one of the cards, or two of the cards in my hand does not bode well. Like, yeah, I guess if I, yeah, could have just sideboarded poorly. Like, obviously if I had, like, you know, a Death Dealer or even a Warden there, I'd be in better shape than sitting on these Thoughtseizes. Though ideally you're trying to break up their curve and prevent them from having Rhino. Alright, so Daroka's Command was almost a good card. It would have been a great card last turn. Right now, I don't think it's doing much for me, though. I can kill one of his guys, and he's still going to attack and kill me. Okay. Yeah. Well, since I lost round one, I think I'll join another 8-man or join a 2-man or something. But, yeah, we're losing this one. Okay. Well, I'll see you guys next round.